after this thing blew up on me, it leaves me without a nickel metal hydride charger. And I kind of need one because I've got a whole bunch of them and more upstairs and in the kids' stuff and all over the place. I could sort of use this one, but I don't want to. I don't really trust it. Watch the other video and kind of see why. So I went out to IKEA and I spent a whole $4 on this little guy. IKEA something. So to do one or two AA or AAA batteries. It's got one LED on it. It's just hidden underneath the cover there. What's it say? Just charging time is between 5 hours and 12 hours, depending on what combination of batteries you got in there. Pair of AA's, it says it'll take 12 hours. Depending up for a 2400 milliamp hour. What is this one? 1500 milliamp hour. So, somewhere between 5 and 9 hours. Nothing super surprising in here. Its output 0.22 amps maximum. Okay, well that doesn't say much. So these batteries, this one, it's only kind of half used. These three though, when I metered them, I took them out of a toy or something, and I was surprised to find that they are dead nuts flat. This guy at least has some juice in the 1.2. Yeah, so that's not too bad. Well, these things are completely just flat as piss on a plate. Nothing. So, I don't even know if these will charge, but let's torture test it, I guess. And we'll see how much it takes to, current it takes. So, source of 5 volts. This is coming from a wall wart that's good for 2 amps. I know it's good for 2 amps because I've used it before up to 2 amps. I'll use this guy here, my charger doctor, 5.3, 5.2, and then these guys, these little charging slots, whoa. It's kind of cool. The AA just sits in there like that. The AAA's nose down into a little slot down there. A jaunty angle using the same negative terminal and just a different positive terminal. So let's get out. Oh, that's not too horrible, I guess. Yeah, okay. So there's those two completely flat AAA's. Plug that into there. So you can't really see it. It's bouncing between 130 milliamps and about 20. It's bouncing up and down. There, it's settled in around. No, it's just bouncing all over the place. Okay, there, it's kind of settled around in 15 milliamps and it drops back down to nothing again. Oh. And the LED on it is blinking. Maybe it's not happy with those. Okay, well, let's knock them out and just put a more normal, give it a more normal charge load there. Single AA. And again, this thing, zoom in on that so you can see it. Yeah. That's odd. I can just let it sit there and buck for a while and see what happens. Or, no, I'm curious. I can let her buck overnight. I want to see what's in this thing. What these Swedes have put in there. Oh, yeah. That's probably better than the book. So what does input half an amp at 5 volts, output 1.4 volts, focus a little bit better, there we go. So 220 milliamps for a pair of AA's, or 110 milliamps for a pair of AAA's, okay. Warning, risk of fire, ETL, blah, 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 blah. Right. Looks like little Torxes. Let's find some and see what's inside this. But this little Swedish Chinese made wonder thing. Did I actually guess right first try? No, really, that was first try. I'm not doing stupid camera tricks here. That's cool. Okay, let's see what's under the screws and behind the quality control label. I suppose since I'm being rough with this thing, I should back up a little bit. There we go, that spudger has just paid for itself. Oh wow, that's actually kind of busy in there. Neato. Is there stuff on both sides of the board? No, it looks like it's a single sider. Okay. So we got four fairly sturdy diodes there, as surface mount diodes go. And we got 1, 2, 3, 4 little transistors of some description. Little capacitor up there. Assortment of capacitors and resistors. And then the brains of the operation. I'm not sure how visible that's going to be on camera. Will you focus? No, you won't. Come on. Is that even right way up? I don't think so. Oh, there we go. Okay, I'll look that up and come back in a second. That Google search didn't go as well as I'd thought. The only thing I could find on this chip was one guy on Reddit 10 months ago looking for information on the same chip, and everybody else saying it's probably proprietary, you'll never find it, good luck. So I dug around a few other Chinese websites and found some claiming to sell something with a similar part number, but nobody with anything exactly the same. So that's a bust. These four diodes though, zoom in a little bit. These four big diodes here are SS16, which are surface mount Schottky diode, in the range from this manufacturer anyway. It's the heavy dutiest surface mount Schottky diode they have. It's good for 60 volts peak inverse, 1 amp forward continuous, 40 amp peak instantaneous for like 8 milliseconds. And operating temperatures negative 65 to plus 150 Celsius. So that's a pretty heavy duty part. It's kind of a neat little charger. So I'm going to now then put my partially discharged 2300 milliamp hour battery on there with this in the circuit and just see what it does overnight. And I'll tack that on at the end here.
So I found another nickel metal hydride battery that's not the same charge level, not the same capacity, but I figured I'd give this thing a torture test and do what you're not supposed to do and mix batteries. But since I am going to be testing it unattended, I'm going to leave it on a concrete floor where it can't burn anything down. And it seems to have settled down to 370 odd milliamps as a very constant. So I guess when it starts up, it, I don't know. Oh, there's a little pulse. Anyway, it seemed to pulse for a while at the beginning, and now it's kind of stabilized. But it's only been running for a little over 20 minutes, so we'll check back on it tomorrow. Okay, about 11 and a half hours has passed. It's down to pretty much no current now. Occasionally pops up. And it's dumped 5,026 milliamp hours into this pair of batteries. And this pair of batteries, let's see now. Okay, that one is 2,000 milliamp hour. And this one is 2,300. Focus. They weren't fully discharged. So, 4,000-ish. There's going to be some inefficiencies and some heating and stuff. But that's kind of cool.